Welcome to the Shambles with Sos Valvo Lynchy for yet another episode. I am Lynchy. Joining me as always on the couch, Sos and a boy who was attacked by a rabid monkey.
Make jokes. I have the worst haircut in the history of mankind. Ladies and gentlemen, have a look. Have a look at my hair. Look at it. Look. What is going on there? It is a it's roadkill. That's what is on my head. It's like I went in there today and I sat on the chair in Just Cuts and said, I need scalp. There's not enough of it going around. So I want people to see my scalp. Really look into it. Look at it. It looks absolutely disgusting. I look like
a frullet. You've got a front mullet.
Oh, it looks bangs, like, it actually looks bangs. Like I'm a Burns victim bangs. And this is growing back. And you know what? When you get a bad haircut, you just chuck on your hat. Watch me with a hat on. Give me that hat. Watch this. It's absolutely...
Got it.
Okay, meant to cover my hair? Hi, I'm from the Make-A-Wish Foundation, and for my final wish, I want to come on the Shambles. I look... I can't put it in words. And, you know, when you people get a bad haircut, you can just, you know, stay indoors, not really go out for a few weeks. I have to come in and film a television show. I'm devastated, so I apologise for my hair and my cap. I really do. Good day.
Whoa.
Glad I got that off my chest.
What a high-octane start.
I know.
Blew my mind.
What is that? You have been carrying that thing around all day, this, and it's irritating
you. So this is my orb.
Your orb. Yeah. The 12 hours? This is your orb?
What's an orb?
What the hell's an orb?
What isn't an orb?
What does that orb do?
It's a time travel machine.
Takes it time travel machine.
That thing that looks like a desk lamp.
No,
is going to take us through time. Is that what you're trying to convince me?
Anywhere you want to go, it's going to take you
2009.
Not going
so
there.
So if I say to you, Lynchy, I want to go to the year 2012, that orb's going to get me there.
No, not this one.
2018.
No. It so can go where? To 20,047.
Whoa!
Wow, the future. What a strange and shiny place.
2046.
This is great.
Sos, why are you a cross-dresser?
Yeah.
Why are you still going to the same hairdresser?
Oh, my God. 49 years later, you'd think I'd learn.
This is amazing. And absolutely the worst. I can't believe there's so much foil in the future.
Oh, man. I can't believe that 40 years later, we're sitting in the same studio doing the same show.
Note to self, buy shares in foil back in 2006.
When we go back, that's the first thing I'm going to do.
Yeah. Hey, guys. Yeah. If this studio looks as cool as it does now, just imagine what it's like outside.
Oh, imagine the world.
It'd imagine be like Melbourne in 2006.
Flying cars and robotic helpers and Robin Williams who grows a heart even though he's a robot.
More aluminium.
Oh, my God.
Let's go.
Yes. Are you ready? Yep. Yeah. I'll have the garden salad with some Coke and a water. And also, I have a disease that prevents me from growing any kind of pubic hair. And my father's an alcoholic.
Too much information, guy.
Anthony.
Yeah?
How are you going?
Good.
Just had a look at your report from this morning.
Yep.
Can I be blunt?
Sure, go ahead.
Cool. You touch my heart, you touch my soul, you change my life and all my goals. I've been addicted to you. Goodbye, my lover. Goodbye, my friend. You have been the one. You have been the one for me. Goodbye, my lover. Goodbye, my friend. Still on for lunch?
Yeah, sure.
Yep. Cool.
Yeah, cool. See you then.
Wally Green! The gardener who's afraid of trees.
Hey,
green. The gardener who's afraid of trees. Words the Shambles can't say at 7:30.
Your mother, like, with a horse.
Words the Shambles can't say at 7:30.
Welcome back to the Shambles with Sos, Valvo and Lynchy, the very special 2046 future episode being replayed back in 2006. It's a bit confusing, a bit like The Matrix, can't explain it right now.
Bear with us.
But you'll get it, eventually.
Well, you know what, this is kind of, I didn't expect this to be the future. Like, I honestly thought things would be a little more high tech than foil.
But, Lynchy, and the future's and all about simplistic. So, simplistic ways.
And hygiene, that's what the foil's about.
Yeah. Yes. Dame Edna glasses.
I knew this is what the future would be like, I would never have come. So what we did is we went back in time and asked people what they thought the future might be. And we'll see if they're right in a little segment we'd like to call Future Back in Time Gutter Talk.
It's a thinker.
Well, we're just asking people today, what do you think the future's going to be like?
In my future?
Yeah.
Better for today.
All right, yeah. Uh-huh, cool, nah. All right.
Tell me something about the future.
That's a very good question.
Yeah. That's why we've hit the streets asking it, because it's a good question.
Yeah.
give us, what do you think fashion's going to be like? Everyone will be in those silver, like, moon suits?
Probably, yeah.
Well, that guy's jacket. His jacket will be in fashion.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're ahead of your time, my friend. Ahead of your time.
It's going to be really crap, probably, because I don't know. I haven't thought about it.
I'm giving you some time to think about it now.
Can I go?
Can you go? I didn't, like, chain you to my ankle. Why? Come back.
Jack, the boats are coming back. Jack, the boats are coming back. Come back.
What do you think the future's going to be like? This lady, she's a mystery wrapped in enigma, wrapped in a coat.
Cool, so what's your name?
I'm Mitch.
Mitch.
Dylan.
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 Siobhan.
Siobhan. And I'm Nathan. And you're watching Video Hits.
I'm looking at, hopefully in the future, we will have a more peaceful world than we have today, and that the conflicts and prejudices that people have will be gone.
All this from an American.
You need to tell us what the future is going to be like.
In the year 2046.
Yeah, precisely in the year 2046.
I reckon Melbourne will probably just be the same, but shitter. Like, it'll be more shit everywhere, and it'll be dirtier.
So, we're getting rid of the use of toilets in the future.
Well, you're not literal shit, but you know. Like,
oh, so you don't literally mean feces. Human feces won't riddle the streets.
Nah.
Well, what do you mean by shit?
Just general crap, like,
Daryl Summers albums.
Yeah.
Australian Idol evict albums, just general crap.
Yeah, there'll be Australian Idol bullshit.
Channel 31 reception.
On everything.
Just crap everywhere.
Yeah, and the Shambles will take over the world.
I wouldn't have a clue, mate, though. I wouldn't have a clue.
Are you from Random, from X Factor?
No.
Good.
We're asking people today about the future. What do you think the world's going to be like in the year 2046, Fidel Castro?
I hope there will not be a Third World War.
Third World War? You think there's going to be a Third World War?
I hope not.
I hope there's not going to be a Third World War either, but it looks to me that you're pretty prepared if there is going to be one.
Oh, yeah?
Like, if we go under attack right now, right now, you're prepared. See, me? I'm gone. I'm standing out. You're prepared for the World War III.
You're looking for some cover, that's all.
Exactly. You're camouflaged. I didn't even see you walking up the street before.
Right.
Yeah, pretty much the same, except everything's 40 years older.
You're still going with that joke. See, this is what I'm talking about. This is what I'm talking about. We're going out. I remember growing up in a country where people, you could go with a camera and people used to give you really good answers. It was pride. That's made you proud to live in this country. It made you proud to go out with a camera and ask stupid-ass questions but get really funny answers in return. That's what I dream of. I dream of this country getting back to the point where I could go out with a camera with my stupid mates and ask a stupid-ass question and get a funny answer in return. Anyway, thanks for your time, mate.
No problem.
Bloody terrific.
It's very optimistic. Why do you think it's going to be bloody terrific?
Well, as long as you're alive and living and you've got a clear mind and conscience, you can do anything in the world you like. Look at me. Have a guess. How old am I?
98.
What do you think the world is going to be like in the year 2046?
2046. I don't know. I'll probably be dead.
You'll be dead?
Yeah.
That's not a very nice attitude to have. How old are you?
I'm 16.
Well, if you're only 16, in the year 2046, you'll only be...
Come quick.
I mean, you're not going to be that old.
Really, 62.
What do you think the future's going to be like? Like, say, 40 years from now?
I don't know. Cars flying around?
Flying cars.
I like flying cars.
Flying planes?
They already fly. Planes already fly. I think that's already happened. Flying planes. What school do you go to?
A lot of people have been saying flying car, but what's the actual advantage? Because you're all still up at the same level. There'll be traffic jam.
Yeah, yes and no.
If anything, it'd make the ozone layer worse because the fumes would go closer and destroy it even. Yeah. I mean... Look at you, just trying to destroy the world one step at a time. What kind of human being are you, and will you stay away from my children and the future of this country? If you think about it, Australia, I'm Sean Lynch. Good night.
What about fashion? What do you think is going to be in fashion with clothes?
Maybe people won't wear clothes.
Just a whole bunch of naked people walking around.
Maybe.
You're a perv. You're a dirty pervert. Look, I just need you to help settle a bet for me, mate. Can you do that for me?
Okay, sorry.
It's $10 riding on this, so don't mess around.
Okay.
That shirt. Now, have you killed an emu or a muppet for that?
What would you like to see in the future?
Well, I'd like to see people be a bit more decent to each other, don't you think? A bit more civility.
Be a good idea.
No.
What about fashion?
I reckon everyone dressed like freaks. Tight, yeah. Kind of fluoro colours and stuff.
Yeah. Like roadworks.
Yeah, definitely.
That's the way of the future.
Yeah. They're setting the trend.
Because all the cars will fly, therefore there's no need for the road, and there's no need for road workers, therefore there's no need for their uniforms, so their uniforms become the fashionable thing to wear out.
Exactly.
It's a full circle moment we've just had.
Yeah.
Good moment.
I feel we're really close now.
Yeah. Same. Can I borrow you for 2 seconds? You're on the run. Got to fight crime.
What do you think the future will be like?
Terrible.
Why?
Well, I think you're going backwards, personally.
What do you mean? No, I'm asking forwards.
No, you're not. You're going backwards.
Excuse me, sir. Sir, can you hear me? Sir, my name's Valvo. I'm a paramedic. I'm here to help you today. I want to ask you a bunch of questions. Sir, can you hear me? I want to ask you a question. What day is it today, sir? Sir, can you tell me what the day is today? Can you feel me press that? Sir, squeeze my finger. Can you feel my finger, sir? How long has he been like this?
All his life.
I can't save him.
Why not?
Because he's a giant tomato. Fair enough. Push.
Now it's time for a Shambles News Break.
Hello and welcome to this special Shambles News Update. I'm Lynchy. To entertainment news now, where Christina Aguilera has narrowly missed out on the lead role in the upcoming remake of the children's classic Strawberry Shortcake. The producers have said she's not the kind of tart they are looking for. Over to you, Sos.
Thanks, Lynchy. This just in, my lunch.
Stir fry.
leftover from hop sings. Could have heated it up a bit more. Over to you, Valvo.
Thank you, Sos. A recent study has revealed that 7 out of 10 people over the age of 75 are still sexually active. The study also revealed that 10 out of 10 people vomited after hearing that statistic. That's all from us this evening. Have a good night.
And that was a Shambles News Break.
Steve, the bad joke neighbour.
That's me. I almost missed you. I was walking along and I almost missed you. Look, I've got another joke for you after last week's joke, because I know you went out and told all your comedy friends out there, and you said, I've got a joke for you, and you told them the joke I told you. Well, here's another one, and you can use it as you wish.
Sure.
Here we go. I will tell the question to the answer that I will give you, and then you can go and tell and laugh and giggle like you did when you were a child. Yeah. Here we go. Here's a joke. Why was the bee's hair sticky?
Don't know.
I'll say it again. Why was the bee's hair sticky? It's because he used the honeycomb.
Steve, the bad joke neighbor.
That's me.
Oh, g'day. I'm the guy from the Beaconsfield mine. The one who got trapped underground and got rescued 12 days later.
Yeah, me too. Rock climbing?
Same. Daylight. Yeah. Good flick.
Meh.
Probably Sylvester Stallone, because that time that he went underground into the tunnel that got blocked off and he let all the people out. That's the plot to Daylight. I've already answered that question. Favourite film, Daylight?
Oh yeah, sorry, yeah.
Oh, favourite food? Tough question. I once ate my own feces.
Oh, that was about day 4.
Never doing that again.
Ah, that was bad. I don't like nachos because it's purely because of the guacamole.
Not in a mine. Is that answer too predictable?
Yeah, no, it is.
I would have to say, you too. Stuck in a moment that you can't get out of.
Yeah. Or I like the Bee Gees, Staying Alive, you know? It's a classic. Mm.
Ha, 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 staying alive,
ha, 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 staying alive. Get more with the people on the dance floor.
No, that's the entrance remix.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. Yeah. You want the original Bee Gees one?
No, I like them both.
No. Can't remix a classic. Ooh, I would say the time I was telling my story of survival on Channel 9 and I wasn't wearing any pants.
Yeah, that was uncomfortable.
Well, there we go. That is it for this special edition of The Shambles, in which I travelled to to the Future.
You did, Sean, and it was a good time. We're happy to have you here in 2046.
Mm. Oh, yeah.
My grandpa would be happy with his bad haircut.
Yeah. Mine would be spinning in his grave.
If you want to know more about the show or anything, you can visit us online at theshambles.com.au or drop us an email, shamblestv@hotmail.com. The year's 2046, but we haven't changed our email address because that would cause confusion.
And we're still selling the same DVD at the same stores, yeah. So why don't you go out and buy it? I mean, it's been 40 years now.
Not
that
DVD players will exist anymore.
Yes. No, but
I'm just assuming. I've only been here for about 20 minutes.
You can implant them into your brain and watch them whenever you like. It's
awesome.
Fantastic.
Awesome. Yeah. Well, for this episode of The Shambles, I was Lynch. He was Sos Jr. He was Valvo Jr. Today's show was The Shambles, and this definitely was The Shambles. I'm hoping this thing works because I want to leave here right now.
Having a look at your report from this morning.
Yeah.
Can I be blunt?
Yeah, sure.
Sure, cool. Can I be blunt?
Sure.
Cool. You touch my heart, you touch my... you touch my heart, you touch...
sure, cool.
Did I disappoint you? Or treat you... You changed my life and all my goals. I've been addicted to you. Goodbye, my lover.
unprofessional.
Oh, the camera girl laughed.
Sorry.
We're doing our best here.
You know, I never stop up. I never laugh.
Yeah, I don't like nachos. It's the guacamole. I don't like nachos. I don't like nachos because of the guacamole. I don't like nachos. I think it's because of the guacamole.
You have been the one for me.
Goodbye, my lover. Goodbye, my friend. You have been the one. You have been the one for me.